And if all this talk about the Iowa caucuses has you a bit confused, you're certainly not alone. Most Californians couldn't tell you how an Iowa caucus works if their life depended on it. That's why Chris Clackham put together this crash course, Caucus 101.
The unusual ritual that is the Iowa caucuses started back in 1972 and is the first official presidential contest of the year. Tonight, in nearly 2,000 precincts across the Hawkeye State, registered voters will meet in churches, schools, and even private homes to make their choice. Each party does it a little differently. The Republicans get underway at 7 p.m. and will vote by secret ballot. It's winner takes all. The candidate with the most votes gets all the Iowa delegates at the national GOP convention. The Democrats get down to work a little earlier, at 6:30. And on that side of the aisle, the caucus goers divide into groups, each group supporting a particular candidate. If a candidate doesn't get 15% of the votes at that particular caucus, its members must join another group. So, second choices are important. Participants can make speeches to try to get more people to support their candidate. And once everyone has made their decision, the precinct chairman calls in the results, and delegates in each county are proportionately assigned. The process can take hours, making it a potentially late night for Democratic candidates. And while it's hard to predict, tonight 120,000 to 150,000 Democrats and 60,000 to 90,000 Republicans are expected to caucus.
Chris Clackham, KCRA, 3 reports.
All right, for a little insight on what's happening here, political analyst Steve Swatt joined us. Steve, how important is Iowa? Does someone who wins Iowa in this caucus, generally people in New Hampshire go, oh, we want to get on board with a winner, or is this just the first stab here?
It's all over the place. Mm-hmm. Take the Republican primary, or the Republican caucus. It is so unpredictable right now. Perhaps as unpredictable and as wide open since 1940, some say, and that's when Wendell Willkie won the nomination and went up against Franklin Roosevelt. But because there's no front runner right now, whoever wins in Iowa will get a boost, and that boost will carry over at least some degree into Iowa, into New Hampshire. Mm-hmm. But Iowa and New Hampshire are totally different states in terms of their demographic makeup. And so, for example, on the Republican side, you have 40% of the Republican voters say they're evangelicals. But in New Hampshire, one-third of the Republicans say they don't go to church on a regular basis. And so Mike Huckabee may do well tonight in Iowa, but not so well in New Hampshire. But other cases we've seen where candidates have come out of Iowa. They got that boost. They went into New Hampshire. They won, mm-hmm. and then got the nomination. Jimmy Carter in 1976, right. For example.
Can you see the Kuciniches, the Christopher Dodds, people like that, some of the periphery candidates looking at Iowa, doing horribly and going, okay, I'm out?
Oh, yeah, I can see that for sure. I mean, because it's the entire campaign schedule is compressed, and with New Hampshire coming only 5 days later, I can see many of these candidates saying, okay, I will give it 5 more days, and then it's do or die.
Right.
But usually they start dropping like flies after Iowa. Many more go down the tubes after New Hampshire.
Yeah, it's a question
by the time
of
it gets to California,
yeah.
There are very few left.
Right, and campaign spending is one thing. We talked about this privately, where John Edwards has been outspent 5-1 by Obama Clinton, yet he's right in there.
Well, he did very well in Iowa 4 years ago, and as mm-hmm. a matter of fact, Richard Gephardt and Howard Dean went at each other with negative ads so viciously at the end of that campaign that John Edwards and John Kerry rose to the top. Gephardt and Dean fell by the wayside. Kerry won by 6 percentage points, but Edwards did well. He's very well known. He does have a good organization. He has organized labor behind him in Iowa, which is important. But the reason he's been outspent for a number of reasons. One, his campaign is strapped for cash, and because of that, he accepted federal campaign matching funds.
Matching.
When you do that, you are limited in right. terms of your spending in every state. Obama and Clinton have enough money they can spend whatever they want.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see what happens with Giuliani and Mitt Romney and McCain tonight as well. It's going to mm-hmm. be a crazy night. Steve, thanks for stopping
sure.
by. Enjoy